Hello guys, welcome back to SVD, and today I want to talk about Mortal Kombat. So I have a customer who asked me about Storm Collectibles when it comes to the Mortal Kombat 11 line. Believe it or not, Storm Collectibles actually already did a Mortal Kombat 11 Scorpion. It came out last year in July. It's based on the Klassic Skin Scorpion, as we can see right here. I'm not sure if it's 100% accurate to the look of the Scorpion, the way the his weapon. I don't know if he actually come with katanas, because this version of the Scorpion has a katanas. So yeah, he has a katana and the wakizashi. So I don't think the Storm Collectibles version come with the katanas at all. So yeah, it is actually the MK11 Scorpion. That's the official figure, I think. But another company, a lot of people have been asking about McFarlane Toys as well. People ask me if they're gonna do the classic Mortal Kombat characters. Well, I think what McFarlane Toys is gonna do is they already did a classic Liu Kang. I think it's called the Fighting Abbot Liu Kang, where basically it's a very half-ass effort, to be honest with you. They just took off his shirt, and you can actually do the mod yourself. You can buy the MK11 Liu Kang, and then you can take off the shirt and the jacket, and then he becomes like the classic Liu Kang. And basically, that's it. I know that one is actually in this weird yellow and black color, which people don't like. If they could have released him in the more, red and black color, that would make a little bit more sense. But it's essentially the same figure, but you're getting less, since you're not getting the shirt, and you're not getting the little, like, you know, the jacket outside or something. I think it's all part of the same outfit, so it's just like, you know. But they do have the license to do all of these if they want to at any time. They can do the classic skin. I'm not sure if they're going to go back and do the original ones. I mean, it would be nice if they do the original 1, 2, and 3 outfits, but I don't see that happening. I think, according to most of the people who are selling the McFarlane toy figures, they're telling me it's most likely they're just going to do the skin pack. Because, there's actually a lot of the skin packs for the Mortal Kombat 11 characters. They have the Mortal Kombat 3 Sonya, and they have the female ninjas of Mortal Kombat 2 already. And then they can also do, like, weird stuff like the Mortal Kombat 9. This is Mortal Kombat 9, yeah. They can do this, and they can do, because there's so many different skins for Mortal Kombat 11, basically, I think NetherRealm and Warner Brothers just like milking it with all these skin packs. Yeah, I think it would make more sense for them to do this than for them to do other stuff. I mean, look at it. There's a Jason Voorhees skin pack for Cabal, and man, these skin packs are just out of control. It's like DLC, and also the DC skin pack where you have Killer Croc as Baraka or something like that. Wow, that actually looks pretty good, and Katana as Catwoman, I guess. Is that Catwoman? It looks like Catwoman. Who's the other guy? I think that's Shang Tsung, right? Shang Tsung as a Batman, the whatever. I'm not familiar with that character. But anyway, someone also asked me, would Hasbro gonna do the Mortal Kombat characters? Because in the 90s, they have the license to do Street Fighter, and they have the license to do Mortal Kombat. I think that's a possibility if they're going to do the O-ring figures, because the O-ring figures are coming back. They recently did a collaboration with Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Power Rangers. So, you know, if they can do Ninja Turtles, I don't see why they can't, you know, get licensing to do, like, the Mortal Kombat characters and the Street Fighter characters again. I don't know if that's going to be very popular, though. Would you guys like to see 3.75-inch G.I. Joes, Mortal Kombat, and the 3.75-inch Street Fighter characters in the those, you know? I don't know. I think those were pretty bad back in the day. I think that's what killed G.I. Joe for me, but some people apparently still likes it. So anyway, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching.